So a few weeks ago, I came across this issue where I did a clean install of Microsoft Office 365 on a client's PC, only to find out that Microsoft Outlook, the classic version that you pay for, wasn't included as part of the installation. And this happened twice, on different computers. Now, I'm aware that Microsoft has started replacing the classic version of Outlook with the new Outlook for Windows app, which is free, but it contains ads. But up until this happened, I was still able to open and use the classic Outlook alongside the new Outlook for Windows app. So I was really confused when I saw this happening. I decided to open an Office 365 app, like Word for example, just to go and verify if Outlook is still part of the Microsoft 365 suite. And yes, it was. I tried doing a search for Outlook Classic in Windows, but it didn't provide any results. I went into the program files where the Outlook and other Office apps executables are usually saved, but Outlook wasn't there. This made me even more confused. It meant that the classic version of Outlook really wasn't installed at all. So I decided to reinstall the entire Office 365 suite again, because I thought that maybe something went wrong with the installation process. But that didn't work either. The classic Outlook was nowhere to be found. At this point, I thought it might just be a problematic update from Microsoft or something, so I decided to give it a few days and just use the new Outlook app for the time being until I could find a solution. Now, just a few days after that, another client came to me saying that Outlook has completely disappeared from their computer and they have no access to their emails. I looked at the computer, I saw the issue, I saw that the new Outlook for Windows was installed and the classic Outlook app is completely gone, just like I explained before. But what's different here is that this was an existing Microsoft 365 installation, not a new installation. Using the new Outlook for Windows was not an option for this client, because they have about 4 email addresses that they've been using for years and have been set up as POP3 with years and years of client data saved in the PST files that they urgently need access to. Now, before I tell you how I fixed this issue and restored the classic Outlook app, let me just explain some core email setup concepts, especially as it relates to the classic version of Outlook and the new Outlook app. If you didn't know, the classic version of Outlook that you pay for has more features than the new Outlook, especially for business and enterprise users. For example, you can use POP3 mail setups with PST files. At the time of this recording, POP3 setups are supported in the new Outlook app, but PST files are not yet. With a POP3 setup, the emails are saved to a PST file, a personal storage file that's saved to your computer. It creates an offline copy of every single email, and you'll always have access to those emails in that PST file. Even if you don't have internet access and the email is deleted from the server, or the entire email account is deleted for that matter. With an IMAP setup, the emails or entire mailbox are saved to an OST file, which Microsoft says is an offline storage file, but in my experience, is not a truly offline copy of everything that's on the server. For example, if you're not connected to the internet and you try to access some of the older emails in a mailbox that's set up as IMAP, it sometimes won't be able to display the contents of that email, because only the latest emails are truly offline. The others are stored in a sort of cache. To read the older emails, you have to be connected to the internet so it can download the email contents from the server. An IMAP setup is like a sync between Outlook and the mail server. If an email is created or deleted in Outlook, it'll be created or deleted on the mail server as well, and vice versa. So for example, if someone gets access to your mail login credentials and they can log in on the server and delete all of the emails, it means all of your emails will be gone forever. It'll be gone from Outlook as well as on the server. But in a POP3 setup, even if someone gets access to your mail details, and they can log in on the server and delete everything off the server, you'll still have access to all of the emails that you saved in Outlook up until the point that Outlook downloaded emails from the server. In a POP3 setup, you can also choose if you want to automatically delete emails from the server after a certain amount of days and when they're deleted from the deleted items in Outlook. An IMAP setup means the mail client, like Outlook, and the mail server are a mirror image of each other, constantly syncing changes. What happens on the one will also happen on the other. While IMAP is the new standard being used these days, it often feels slow and just doesn't work as well for some people when compared to a POP3 setup, like the client whose emails disappeared. Now, let me tell you how I restored the classic Outlook app and solved the issue. I started doing some research online and came across this Reddit post where the poster stated that Outlook Classic was no longer installed and that it has been replaced with the new Outlook app. The user also stated that they were able to download the classic Outlook app from the Microsoft Store. Something I didn't even know was possible until I found this Reddit post. I'm really glad they provided a download link to it because I tried doing a Google search for it, but to my surprise, there were no results for the classic Outlook app on the Microsoft Store, only results for the new Outlook for Windows app, which was quite interesting to say the least. But anyway, I downloaded and installed the classic Outlook app from the Microsoft Store, and the issue was resolved. As soon as I opened the classic Outlook, everything was exactly like before, because the Outlook mail profile wasn't deleted from the computer, so Outlook just read the mail profile and put everything back in place. All email accounts were still set up and working, and the client was able to access their old emails from the PST files like they were able to do before the new Outlook took over. So after confirming that all the emails have been restored, I went and uninstalled the new Outlook app and everything has been good since. The new Outlook app hasn't been installed automatically again, nor has the classic Outlook disappeared again. Now also on this Reddit post, the poster and some users in the comments also mentioned that you can add some registry keys that might prevent this from happening again, so if you're interested, you can go ahead and do that too. Now you might be wondering, why am I making such a big deal about this? Why not just use the new Outlook and stop living in the past trying to use older technologies like POP3? Well, firstly, the classic version of Outlook is a paid app that is superior when compared to the new Outlook, at least at the time of this recording. It's part of the Microsoft Office suite, which has always been a paid software. You can't purchase the classic Outlook as a standalone app, and the Office versions that include it are priced way higher than those that do not include it. Even if you download the classic Outlook for Windows app from the Microsoft Store, you still need an Office license to use it. Microsoft should not be intentionally removing or hiding an app that a consumer has paid for without informing them or asking consent first, and then force them to use a new, free app that contains ads and does not even include the same functionality as the paid version. I know of some people who purchase the Office suite just so they can have access to Outlook. There are so many other good and free replacements when it comes to apps like Word, Excel, and PowerPoint, but there's no really good free Outlook alternative. I mean, instead of developing a new Outlook app that's worse when compared to the original, Microsoft could have just made the classic Outlook app free and then started distributing it as a standalone app. In my opinion, this would have been way less disruptive than what they're currently doing. But what do you think? I'm curious to know your thoughts about this. Please let me know what you think down in the comments of this video. Also, if you're interested in getting access to the infographic that I used throughout this video, I'll provide a link to the Gumroad page down in the description of this video. Once you get there, you can download it for free by just entering 0 as the amount and then proceeding with the order. But if you are willing and able to pay for it, just enter an amount that you feel is fair for the infographic, then proceed with the order. And I'll just thank you in advance right now for supporting my content. I really appreciate it, and it helps me to continue creating content full time. But with all of that being said, I just want to give a special shout out to all of my YouTube members. I know I haven't been posting a lot lately, but I really appreciate your support as always, and I'll talk to all of you guys soon.